Welcome to the world of mathematical analysis or real analysis. We are familiar with the real number system from our high school onwards. So what are real numbers? Let us denote them by R. R stands for the set of all real numbers. So what's our familiarity with this system? Through different branches, one can approach this set. And usually one has to work with algebra, the branch of algebra, as well as geometry. In fact, the notions of calculus also will allow us to enter into this magnificent set of real numbers. So by algebra, I mean usual operations of addition, multiplication, and their interrelating properties, and ideally takes you to understand R with the algebraic structure. Geometrically, if somebody is trying to analyze what exactly is R or to understand what is R, for example, at least we know that the number line concept, which says that a straight line, if you are looking at the points on the straight line, as well as this set of real numbers are keeping a one-to-one correspondence. So say theoretically we are saying that they are equivalent. That is the preliminary notions of geometry to this world. Obviously algebra is doing all finite process, and the world of calculus or the branch of calculus allow us to think much nicer aspects of real numbers. Given through limits, as well as notions of continuity, differentiation about functions and all. So these are our various branches in mathematics, which actually gives or which actually stresses that R is rich in structures, algebraic, geometric, calculus or analysis, whatever it you are going to call. So let us try to understand this system. So while looking at the system, as sets, we can simply display like this. R stands for set of all real numbers. Q stands for all rationals. Z stands for set of all integers. N stands for set of all natural numbers. Things are fine, okay. Till you are asking a question. For example, if I'm simply asking an innocent question, what's a real number X, you mean? X is a real number. X belongs to R. So what does it mean? Okay. You'll think that, okay, we know about the real numbers. Okay, X is a real number. A moment's thought, we try to say, tempting to say that, okay, yes, if X is a real number, then either it is a rational number or it is an irrational number. Okay, once you know about rational number, you can simply escape that. Oh, a number which is not a rational is an irrational. Okay. For the time being, it is okay. But still, what is a rational number then? So we will try to come back now. That then, certainly, you will try to look at X. Oh, I am going to call it is a rational number, provided that has the form something like P by Q. Obviously, what are P and Qs? P and Q are integers. Okay, P and Q are integers. Used to give that Q not equal to 0 also. They are all integers. Oh, fine. Then what are integers? So that leads you to the left end again. Oh, then what are integers? Okay, it is a set. What it consists of? It consists of 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. As well as 0, minus 1, minus 2, etc. on the left end. Oh, then what are these fellows? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. Another copy like that and some 0. Okay. So what are these 1, 2, 3, 4? Finally, our search will end up with this. That is 1. So I have to answer what they are. 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., etc., etc. So this is what is going to be called as a natural number. This setup we are used to call as integers. This is rational setup for T by Q forms. Obviously, P and Q are from integers and Q is away from 0. Then try to answer that set of all X's which is a rational as well as an irrational fellow, also you are clubbing together, you are going to get R. But the whole question now subsumes to the question of what exactly are natural numbers, God-given natural numbers. There are many ways of giving the proper axioms and building up the whole business, N to Z, Z to Q, Q to R. We are not going to do it now in a very elaborate manner. At least some properties of all these system of numbers we will just mention, essentialities I can say, and we will try to understand what exactly the system are, how it is related. And so we are not going to define what exactly our axiomatic way or anything to what are natural numbers, what are Z and all. We'll just take it for granted in these notations. Whenever I'm saying that N is a set of natural numbers, it means the set consisting of, with our symbols, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So, set theoretically, all these things are satisfying for us up to some extent. And operations also you can give it, because all these numbers are not merely interesting for us just because of assets. Their operations are also important for us. Addition, multiplication, etc. That also you have to couple with this. So, theoretically, this involvement is fine. Now, even with set theoretically, some questions are there. If you are interested, N is there, Z is there, Q comes, then R comes, which is a bigger one, which is smaller one in this containment, you can look at. Is there as many members what you are inside N is available in Z or in Q or in R? Such questions, we have seen it before in algebra courses, but somebody can say that, see, two sets are looking alike or equivalent whenever they are having a one-to-one correspondence, the bijection existing between that. Then, in our old algebra days, we have seen N as well as Z, in fact Q, they are all having the same class of cardinality, which means you can have bijections from N to Z as well as Z to Q also. But whenever you are moving for R, it is much a bigger set than this, you can say. So one has to look at the number of elements, how to say it in abstract way. That here, somewhere we have seen such things. Even for N, if somebody is asking us theoretically, is it how many elements are there in N? At first, the question may be stupid, but okay, it's not a finite set, you can say. It's an infinite set. So what's an infinite set? A set which is not finite. So what's a finite set? Oh, what is a finite set then? A proper definition is needed. But that is, in some way it is easy. Suppose you have a set consisting of three elements, whatever we are keeping in our mind, how will you understand it well? Suppose a set A is with me. A, it consists of small A, B, C, R members. Why you are calling that it is having three elements? We can depend on these natural numbers, I mean this set N, to describe that idea. It's very easy. See, look at N as a set. It is not merely as a set, as I'm saying before. And built-in ordering is there, first, second, third, etc., etc. It actually comes from the order relation less than. So with that N, what you can observe is that any non-empty subset of N is going to have least element. The beginning is always good. So look at the entire set of natural numbers. One is the beginner. So if I'm simply writing down a set starting from that beginning, 1, 2, and 3, and I'm calling that N3, for example. 3 stands for how many comes actually. So if N3 as a proper subset of this N, if I am going to write, then this N3 is going to have a one-to-one correspondence with this ABC. So I can simply call that as many elements in this N3 I wanted to call, that is the characteristic for the number of elements in A here. So obviously that allows us to say that number of elements in A is 3. But such a notion one can easily extend to any number. For example, you take any natural number, small n I may denote. If you want to say that a set is having n elements, small n elements, what will you do? Just look at this section, n. N is a section, I mean, it starts a beginning part of natural numbers, beginning with 1, 2, 3, etc., and end up with n. And you just see that your given set S is having a connection with that, something like x1, x2, etc., xn may exist with proper 1, 1 on to correspondence. So that is, that gives the notion of finite set. How you say that? A set is said to be finite if it is having a 1, 1 on to a bijective correspondence with n for some small n. That is enough. If you want to define a finite set, that is more than enough. Then you can simply say or give the definition, any set which is not a finite is called, it's a infinite set. Empty set also you can call it as finite. So finite world, that as well as infinite world, is in some way we can enter through that way. But that is not the end of the story. As I mentioned, even talk about this, structures like less than and all the things are going to come. So what about, even set theoretically, what about Z and Q and R? With a little effort, you can see that Z is also going to be as many elements, or whatever you are calling here, as many elements in N you have, exactly you want to say such number of elements are in Z. Number of elements is more or less, it is reserved for finite sets. The right terminology is cardinality actually. So for to use it properly, some more set theoretical notions are in need. We will give it such notions in the sequel, but for the time being, let me just make you remember that. See, after the finite state, the first infinite set it appears for us is nothing other than that natural numbers. But it is an infinite set, simplest infinite set. Then, so we will try to look at, compare with n, if you want to look at, that n, any set, if it is having a bijective correspondence with n, that is looking alike like n, or just you can write it as something like 1, 2, 3, 4, relabeling like that. Then you just call such a set is a denumerable set. So if A is a set, and if it is having a 1, 1 onto mapping with our natural numbers, remember that n is the full set of natural numbers. Now, in this setup, we'll call that A is a denumerable set. So, we have finite sets, denumerable set, or you can say countably infinite also, you can say, instead of denumerability. Countability and countability is another word. I mean, countable, we used to say set is said to be countable. In our text, we are using like this, a set is said to be countable either it is finite or denumerable. So these terminologies will be helpful for us in handling the set theoretic notions. So what you are going to see is N, Z, with some more effort, Q, by looking at set cross set kind of things, we'll say that they are all going to be countable sets. And, but R is not. That is a set theoretic understanding of all the system for the time being. Obviously, we are not interested only in these kind of aspects. Some more structures, as you have seen about algebra, geometry, as well as calculus, we have to discuss. So look at, set theoretically, this is the way to understand the whole system. N is sitting inside Z, Z is sitting inside Q, Q is sitting inside R. But remember, N is sitting inside Z, but this N, whenever you are denoting 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., not only set theoretically, as we know that we have the operations, we have the addition available here. I mean, multiplication is also available with the N. In our experience, we have seen that whenever you are going for cell, you have extend this addition as well as multiplication there also, and Q also, and we know very well about R also is equipped with addition as well as multiplication. So that structures, that's algebraic structures also we have to look at whenever you are discussing the number system. So algebraic operations, if I mean, so look at natural numbers. So on natural numbers, suppose I am taking two natural numbers, M. I know what are natural numbers. They are 1, 2, 3, 4 in notations for us. Let me take two of them. See, for simplicity, I can just take, suppose I am taking 2 and suppose they come 3, I can add them. So this addition, I will answer that it is 5. 5 is again inside the set N. It won't go out of doing this operation. Operation of addition. So addition is an operation. Very formal way of talking is something like that. What are you doing in this process? You are taking a pairing, 2 and 3. Not simply a pairing, 2 to 3 you are adding. So an ordered pair. 2 first, 3 next, an ordered pair you are taking. This ordered pair is going to give me an output as 5 by doing 2 plus 3. So 2 plus 3 is defined through this way. So what we are trying to do is that we are actually defining a function f which takes our 2, 3 to 5. So where this 2, 3 comes, it's an ordered pair of natural numbers. So we are looking at a function f from n cross n to n again. So take two natural numbers. First you are taking 2, second you are taking 3. Both are from natural numbers. So our input is from n cross n. That pairing is associating a natural number again, 5. That's also here. So we say that this function is, in general, we are saying that it is a binary operation. 2 are the ordered pairing as given. So among that 2 numbers output, input, you will associate this 5. So addition, one can see it as a function from n cross n. Not only addition, multiplication also do the same way. Because suppose I am again starting at the 2, 3, I can just associate this pair, ordered pair, 2 into 3, 6. So that also gives you that I am working with n cross n now, but now with multiplication. So n cross n to n, in that way if I am looking, multiplication also can be seen as a function. So they are all binary operations and we will master it through the algebra course what we are going to do. But for the time being, I am just taking the definition of this operation. I mean binary operation. A binary operation simply means in any set, not only with R or N or anything you can take, any set you can look at. But at least if I am working with the system here, especially on natural numbers, addition, I may denote from here, n cross n to n, it works. It gives you a pairing m, n. M and n are natural numbers. M is first, n is next. Then I can attach m plus n. That is again a natural number. Now, usually we say that addition is going to be closed under, addition is having the property of closure, which means you are working this operation, the system is still closed. Don't go out of the system if you are doing this operation. That is what binary operation is well defined. We mean by that. Okay, so just look at some properties of such operations which you are very much familiar. See, look at 2 as well as 5, two natural numbers added together. It will give another natural number by the property that it is having the closeness or closure property we used to say. So addition is closed. It won't take you out of the system. The natural numbers won't go out. Two natural numbers added together is again a natural number. This is one property we have seen from the school days onwards. But addition is actually giving in between two elements, first and second. Suppose you wanted to answer 2 plus 5, I know. Suppose I am trying to answer with plus 3, then what we know, 2 plus 3 you can, 2 plus 5 you can add first. It will give you a natural number by the closure. Add with one more. That also guarantees that you will get a natural number. But then one can obviously ask the question, if I am doing 5 and 3 first and 2 is added with that, will they get the same in output? Yes, that is guaranteed through the associative. You can associate the elements like this in as whichever be the fashion you like. Three members are given for you. You can perform the addition first and just add that, or just do your operations here and make 2 first. You will get the same thing. That is what is usually called as associativity. So we know that natural numbers under addition is closed under, it is closed, and secondly, it satisfies associative law also. Even if you are looking at commutativity, is also known for us. 2 plus 5 is going to give you 5 plus 2 also. So the order is immaterial. 2 plus 5, 5 plus 2, both will give the same answer. So usually we will call that it is a commutativity. Commutativity for addition. So remember, n, even with a set of natural numbers, if you are trying to look at plus as well as, okay, even multiplication also you can think about, but just before that, n under addition is having its properties. Okay, one more moment we will spend with these notions. We are getting 2 plus 5 as 7 because of the closure. But then one tempted to ask that very natural question. Okay, 2 plus 5 is 7. So 2 plus what will give you 7? That is the answer you are putting from n. I have a candidate in n, 5. But that is a genuine student or enthusiastic way if you are asking. You can elaborate that question. Suppose I am writing 2 plus, what will give you 2? 2 is a natural number. So what answer I have to put it? Is there any candidate to put it here? Even option. In natural numbers, you have no candidate to put it here. So you have to extend the system. See, for example, if you have ready to introduce 0, 2 plus 0 is going to give you 2. So this natural number system need an extension. We will call that whole numbers, just adjoining that 1, 2, 3, 4, we will adjoin 0 also. Once you are introducing 0, this gives an answer. More than that, 2 plus 0 is giving 2, as well as 0 plus 2 also same is that. So that system develops or extends well. So W, whole numbers are coming out, plus you can talk about. So an additional property comes, like 0, if you are giving such additional property also is going to come. Any natural number added with 0 will give the same thing. That is an additional property. But one may not stop the questions like that. One can also elaborate these questions, or we can rethink. 2 is applied for us. What will give you 1? But the answer is, we are keeping in our mind, is just minus 1. So, but what is minus 1? Or negative of 1? It's additive inverse we used to call it for such long years. So minus 1 has to be introduced. So minus 1, once you are introducing, you will be reaching at z, which are the set of integers. So that is how the development of number system took place. So we need inverses. What is an inverse then? If you are giving m, it's an integer, then one can obviously have a candidate we are denoting it as minus m. On addition, it is going to give us the previous element, the identity element, 0, which actually serves like this. So once these additive inverses are also with you, such a system is very fine. So from n, if you are moving to z, With addition, if you are discussing, the extension to set under this addition is much nicer. It is closed under addition. Set, if you are looking at it, is closed under addition. It is going to have associativity. Additionally, you have an element called a nice element called zero. We'll call that identity or addition, because on addition with this element, it gives the identity of every element. And also we observed every element in set is selected. A member, you can find out, which you are calling its additive inverse, on addition will give back the identity element zero. Finally, you can answer the order is again immaterial. That is, M plus N is going to be same as N plus M in set also. So set is the set we are denoting as set of integers. If you are looking at it, is not merely a set. If you are equipped Z with addition, we know that all these five properties are there. First of all, one is addition is closed under the roof of Z, which is closure. Secondly, you are having associativity and existence of an identity element. We will denote it as by zero, and inverse and negative of that thing also is there for every element. Existence of additive inverse and commutativity is also. The first properties, except that commutativity, if you are having such a system, we used to call that a group. That is the concept of a group. So set, if you are looking at set of all integers, what you are already known for us, this set with the addition structure, I'll call it like this, set with addition is going to be a group, which means this plus satisfies the previous things. As I mentioned, closure, it is closed under the operation, it is associative, and existence of identity element for addition, and inverse exist, additive inverse exist for all every element in set. These four properties are enough to say that this set under this operation is a group. So groups are really nice things. N is not a group. Natural numbers is not a group under addition. Even whole numbers are also not satisfying that, because additive inverses are not there. But set is the first example we are seeing that it forms the structure of a group. In algebra, that is more or less in detail we will look at into the factor. Additionally, another property is there, a plus b same as b plus a for this set element, any elements a and b in set. That property is the commutativity. Commutativity is also with us, we'll say that is an abelian property, or we can say that commutative property or abelian property. Such things means commutative group, you say. So Z under addition is a commutative group. One can actually think about what happens for Z under multiplication also. So if I'm looking at multiplication, even from the natural numbers onwards, I can ask this question. Natural numbers under multiplication, it is easily seen that it is close to natural numbers. You multiply together, again a natural number. Associativity is guaranteed. Even multiplicative identity 1 is available in natural numbers. Inverses, multiplicate inverses, you will miss it. That questions like this, if see, even in set, the same question is not going to give you answer. For example, 2 is an integer. Do you have a candidate which I can put it here, which will give you, for example, 1? You have to put 1 by 2 definitely. But that 1 by 2 is not in set. It comes from the notions of rationals. So further extensions are in need. So Q emerges, rational numbers emerges, which gives the multiplicative inverses. But obviously remember, multiplicative inverses for non-zero elements, because zero is already an additive identity there. So that is how the system extended to Q. So we have seen all these things. You can just look at what are the properties of Q, the set of rationals, but we know it already under addition as well as under multiplication, either design or signature like this. So Q under addition as well as multiplication you think about. But just before that, one can look at Z under addition as well as multiplication. But Z under multiplication, if you are looking at, you will miss the multiplicative inverse definitely, even for non-zero Zs. But you will get it in Q at first. Z usually used to call that is a ring. Later you will study that. But what about Q? Q with addition and multiplication, you're fine. Again, what's fine? I mean, Q under addition is going to be a group. Q under addition is a group. Okay, it's an abelian group. In fact, Q under multiplication is also going to form a group if you are not looking at zero element. So Q star, I mean, right? Or Q minus zero. All non-zero elements in Q under multiplication forms a group. Just avoid zero, then all rational numbers you can get multiplication. It's just an abelian group you will. More things, you have addition, you have multiplication. So even with Z and even natural numbers, one can ask the compatibility of this addition and multiplication. That is, suppose I am taking a rational number X, I may take another rational number Y. I can add them, X plus to get X plus Y. I can multiply with Z. Then naturally one can ask, X into Z I can do, Y into Z I can look at, I can taking the product, then I can add. So add two rational numbers, then multiply. Will it give the same effect as multiply first and then add? They're going to be same. Which means we used to call them as a distributive laws. So distributive laws. One, the other side also you can talk about Z, you can put it here and you can Z into X plus Y same as Z X plus Z Y. So they are usually called distributive laws. So Q satisfies all these properties under the usual addition as well as multiplication. So discussion of number system in this level will give us the algebraic structure in detail. Let us look for R now. Set of all real numbers. So what are real numbers? Such a question. First of all, see, rationals we know, at least we are defined like all P by Q forms. P and Q are integers, Q not equal to zero. So the next question is, what about, why you need real numbers then? Even rational numbers you are satisfactory with addition and multiplication. We used to say that whenever Q is having under addition and multiplication with the distributive laws, we used to say that such a system is a field. Okay. These notions we'll elaborate in algebra. So why you are going to the set of real numbers from Q? Q, they are rationals. R, we are going to call real numbers. Here we know it consists of all sets of the form, all numbers of the form P by Q. PQ are in Z. In Q I can just away from zero. What are R's? Either some number which is not of this form. So what is your first example which is not going to be a rational number? I think obviously we will try to give some root 2 or root 3 or something like that. So such members are existing or not? You have to prove it. Or at least such members are not available in Q and we are going to discuss it. So to understand whether root 2 is existing or not, how will you answer whether root 2 is existing? Two questions are there. Is root 2 exist? If it, then how will you reach at root 2? Because so all previous steps you look at, natural numbers are there, whole numbers were there, integers were there, then Q came. So we have reached that Q by taking understanding Z. Z coming from W. W emerges out from N. So So if you are looking at R, it is coming from Q. Fine. How? Root 2 is not going to be available in Q is our belief. To prove it, at least you have seen, some of you might have been seen. In such a day, if it happens that root 2 is not available in Q, how will you catch hold of root 2 using Q or anything? Some way is there. Definitely, our first answer, if somebody is asked with what is root 2, how will you answer that? Think for a while. How will you give a justification for root 2? Whether it exists or not. Algebraic operations are much, it won't satisfy you much in this deal. Most of you, I think, will think about what is root 2 if the question is, may think about a right angle triangle. So, one unit if you are taking, because once you are looking at a square, for example, or a right angle triangle also you can think about, of side 1, then if this measurement is 1 and this measurement is 1, obviously another measurement AC will come out, and Pythagorean school will give that this fellow is going to be root 2. That was our first notion. And you will just put this on the number line, this measurement. This was our practice in the geometry. So using geometrical way, you are somehow convinced that such a number exists and that is not going to be in Q. That also we will try to prove. So all these things are with us. With that, we are trying to all that such kind of numbers, root 2, root 3, etc., etc. Such kind of numbers also you are adjoining and you will be getting R. You have to study that transition in detail, Q to R, how you will move. So we will answer all these questions in the proper sequence. But at least whenever you are looking at R, R with addition as well as multiplication, you look at. We know all the properties we are familiar with. So from our experience of algebra, R under addition and multiplication is a field. So it's a, what I mean by that is, again, you can look at X and Y are two real numbers. You can, under addition first you can discuss. They can add, it will be again a real number. Associativity also it satisfies, which means X plus Y added with another Z is also going to give X plus Y plus Z. This is true for every X, Y, Z. In R, there exists an element called the additive identity denoted by 0 in R such that x plus 0 is going to give x, which is going to be 0 plus x for every x in R. And inverse also is there, that is, any real number x is supplied for you, you denote a minus x, just a notation, x plus that minus x is going to be giving you this zero element, which is also satisfying minus x plus. Finally, you can say that x and y are real numbers, x plus y is same as y plus. These are the properties. In fact, it says that R under addition is an commutative group. In the next setup, you try to look at multiplication structure, R under multiplication you look at, then change all the operation signs here, then you will get x into y, so x into y is again closed. Here also one can change the business, wherever addition is happening, you just change it into multiplication and think about all these things. That is, associativity in this situation, you say that x into y into z will give you x into y into z. Instead of 0, existence of multiplicative identity, you have to say. So there exists, you have to change the situation to there exists 1, which we call the multiplicative identity, such that x into 1 is going to give you x, which is same as 1 into x. It is true for every x. So inverse also, for every x, you have to be careful, you are with the multiplication. So for every x, you can say for every non-zero x. So I will rewrite, for every x which is non-zero, there exists an element in R which is called the, or denoted by x inverse or 1 by x, whichever you like, such that x into that fellow or x inverse is going to give you 1, multiplicative identity here, which is also giving you 1 by x into x. Finally, commutativity is also true. So R star I may write, I mean R minus 0, it means the set of all real numbers minus 0. Right? This R minus 0 is also a group, which is a commutative group under multiplication. Finally, as I have seen before, x and y are said and given, x plus y into z is going to give you x z plus y z. Similarly, z into x plus y also give me z x plus z y. So these are the familiar properties like we have studied. So we will start from that. Our analysis course, there are two ways of approaching the thing. Either from natural numbers and develop the entire system up to R like this. But we have just gone through all this. Our strategy is from the top. We'll simply say that R is a set with two operations, binary operations, addition as well as multiplication. And it is going to be a field. It is going to be building very safe now. It has two operations, additions, multiplication, which satisfies all the properties that we have seen, only that property. So for addition 5, multiplication 5, connecting them two more. These 12 properties. So where will we start up? We will begin like this. Our methodology is this. If somebody is asking what about real number system for us, we will do like this. R, the set of real numbers, is equipped with an addition, I mean a binary operation, equipped with another binary operation multiplication. You may denote either like this or like this. So this structure, R as a set, addition and multiplications are operations on that, which satisfies the above discussed 12 properties. Very simple. Under addition, whatever be the things you have listed so far, that you have. R with multiplication also like that, how they are mingled together. So you will simply start like that. R is a field. R is not a field. R with this usual addition and multiplication is not mine. So, but instead of that, we will see R for us is this. With all our symbols, we will use like this. So that structure is very rich. We can just do this 12 properties like we have written. That will allow you to understand everything about R. We can just view down now. How Q sit inside, N sit inside, and etc. It's very easy. Once you are assuming R like this, things are very, very easy. So our beginning is like that. For us, real numbers is a field. It's equipped with two binary operations, addition and multiplication. And it has that previously described 12 properties, and we call that it is a field.